Let us continue ionic equilibrium. In ionic equilibrium, Lowry-Bronsted concept we are taking. In the Lowry-Bronsted concept, we are taking relative strength of acids and bases. Now first we will take strong acids. We will take strong acids are HClO4, Hi, HBr, HBr, H2SO4, H2SO4, HCl, HNO3. These are what in the sense strong acids we said. These are strong acids. Then we are writing a H3O plus. We are writing H3O plus. Next we will go for a weak acids. We are going for weak acids. HSO4 minus. Then HF HNO2, HF hydrofluoric acid, HNO2 nitrous acid, acetic acid, carbonic acid, hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen cyanide, ammonium ion, then water. Now we'll say about weak acids. We'll say these are what in the sense weak acids. Those are weak acids, we can say. Next, we will take some more compounds. One is NH3, OH minus, H2, CH4. This we will take. Now we can say that now we will take H2, we will take. This H2 we will pass into H2 gas, we will pass into water. This H2 I will write it as H, single bond H. Wantedly, let us shift the bond this side. So this hydrogen loses the bond, therefore getting positive charge. This hydrogen gains the bond, gains an electron, therefore -1 and having lone pair. This we have done this one wantedly we have done. Okay. This H plus combines with water to give H3O plus, and this H minus is there. Now this H2 donates H plus to water and becomes H minus. Therefore H2 is an acid. Okay. This water takes H plus and becomes H3O plus, therefore it is a base. As per backward reaction, H3O plus donates H plus to H minus and becomes water, therefore it is acid. H minus takes H plus from hydronium ion in the backward and gives H2, therefore H minus is a base. Now we will see acidic strength of H2, we will see. And acidic strength of hydronium ion, we will see how it will be there. Then we will see acidic strength of hydrogen and acidic strength of water, we will see. Let us compare this. Okay. Now we will take a compound called sodium hydride. The sodium hydride formula is NaH. Sodium Na hydride H. In all the compounds available, whether nature or practical, in all the compounds, if sodium is there in whatever the compound, sodium will show certainly +1. Sodium present in whatever the compound, sodium will show plus 1. Okay, so why sodium is showing plus 1 in the sense, in the periodic table the group 1 is alkali metals, they will show plus 1 generally in the compounds. They will donate one electron for the formation of compounds. So sodium shows plus 1 charge in sodium hydride. Now sodium hydride is the molecule, we can say, otherwise compound we can say. For this net charge is 0. For any molecule, for any compound, how the net charge will be there means that should be 0. So in order to have 0 net charge, hydrogen should have how much? Minus 1. Hydrogen should have minus 1 charge. This is sodium hydride. This sodium hydride is added into water. This sodium hydride is added into water. Immediately, hydrogen gas will be liberated. And sodium hydroxide is produced. How this reaction takes place, that we will see. Water we can write H plus OH minus. Now this H minus takes this H plus and becomes hydrogen gas. This sodium ion takes hydroxide and becomes sodium hydroxide. This reaction is vigorous. This reaction is vigorous reaction. That means this is vigorous reaction in the sense, here the reaction will take place completely or not, you would say. The reaction will take place completely. That means this also will attain equilibrium, no doubt. This process also will attain equilibrium. But this equilibrium lies almost what we can say means right. For this equilibrium constant will be very high. This equilibrium lies almost right. This indicates that in this reaction, backward is dominating or forward is dominating, you think it. In this equilibrium, in the top, in the screen top, we have written equilibrium. In this equilibrium, backward will dominate or forward will dominate, you think it. That means we can say here backward is dominating, forward is not at all taking place. Why do we say forward is not at all taking place? If forward is taking place, then in the atmospheric air, hydrogen can't be present. Of course, hydrogen present in the trace percentage in the atmosphere. That also will not be present if forward is taking place. If forward is occurring, then hydrogen will not be present in the atmospheric air. Therefore, we can say forward is not taking place, only backward is taking place. Sir, only backward is taking place in the sense, how the acidic strength will be there? Acidic strength of hydrogen and acidic strength of hydronium ion. Backward is dominant, forward is nil, almost nil. That indicates hydronium ion is having higher acidic strength when compared to hydrogen. Hydronium ion acidic strength is high. Then, hydrogen and water acidic strength we'll see. Forward is nil in the sense, hydrogen is not donating H plus, water is not taking H plus, that is the meaning. Therefore, water is not taking H plus means it is not acting as base. Why? Because acidic strength of water is greater than hydrogen. Acidic strength of water is greater than hydrogen, that's why hydrogen is unable to give H plus to water. For this water, acidic strength is high. For this hydrogen, acidic strength is less. Therefore, it is unable to give H plus to water. Okay. So, if acidic strength falls under like this category, that means acidic strength of given substance is even less than that of water, then that acid is called a very weak acid, we can say. These are very weak acids. Ammonia, OH minus, hydrogen, CH4, hydrocarbons, These are very weak acids, we can say. Okay, so that how the acids are there means like this, acids are classified. Strong acids means that acidic strength is greater than hydronium ion. Weak acids means that acidic strength is less than hydronium ion but greater than water. Very weak acid means that acidic strength is less than even water. Okay, sir. Now we have classified acids. What about strength of these acids? That we will see. Strength of these acids. Okay. Next, we will take this one. We will take here in this equilibrium. We can say that backward takes place dominantly. Forward is almost nil. And this equation also we have seen that in the screen bottom equation you see. In this equation also we have seen that this reaction is vigorous. That means H minus can exist in aqueous solution or cannot exist in aqueous solution. H minus is stable in water or not stable in water. This indicates since it is vigorous reaction, H minus cannot exist in water. H minus is unstable in water. H minus immediately reacts with water. Okay, H minus immediately reacts with water. H minus cannot stay in water, sir. Next we will see. Now we will take this OH minus. This OH minus we are taking. This OH minus is very weak acid, we said. Why is it so? Why we are saying this OH minus is very weak acid? That point we will see. Now we are taking a what in the sense OH minus plus water, okay, gives. Now OH minus is we have to take this is as acid, this as a base we have to take in order to write the equation. Now OH minus how to write we will see. So oxygen, hydrogen. Hydrogen is having one electron in its valence shell. Oxygen comes under group number 6A. Therefore 6 electrons present in its valence shell. Now we will write the bond. And OH minus in the sense a negative charge we will give to oxygen. For my negative charge, we have to give additional electron. Okay, OH minus is this. Okay. Now what we have to do in the sense, let us shift the bond like this. Let us shift the bond like this. If we shift the bond like this, what will happen means from here H plus detaches. H plus comes out. That H plus will be taken by water and becomes what in the sense hydronium ion. Hydronium ion. Here what is remaining in the sense O2 minus. Why? Because this oxygen already is having 3 lone pairs. Now it takes this bond pair, therefore another lone pair. So 4 lone pairs will be there. This oxygen gains this bond, gaining an electron, therefore another negative charge, therefore totally 2 minus. This is called what in the sense oxide. Now as per this, we can say this OH minus is a donating H plus and becoming oxide, therefore it is acid. Water takes H plus from OH minus and becomes hydronium ion, therefore base. As per backward, we will say hydronium ion is becoming water by donating H plus, therefore acid. Oxide becomes OH minus as per backward by taking H plus, therefore base. Okay, now we will see. OH minus acidic strength. We will see acidic strength of OH minus and acidic strength of hydronium ion. We will see. Then we will take acidic strength of OH minus and acidic strength of water. These we will compare. Okay. Now let us take the compound called sodium oxide. We will take a compound. What compound in the sense sodium oxide we'll take. We are taking sodium oxide. That formula is Na2. Sodium oxide formula is Na2. This sodium oxide we will dissolve in water. This sodium oxide we will dissolve in water. What we will get? What we will get in the sense? We will get a sodium hydroxide. This is obtained. You just dissolve sodium oxide in water. If you dissolve sodium oxide in water, what we are getting in the sense sodium hydroxide. Why? In which case like this possible? Here we have taken oxide. Here we have taken oxide, sodium oxide. We have taken oxide formula O2 minus. We are dissolving in water. We are getting what in the sense hydroxide. We are getting. We are not getting oxide in the aqueous solution. That means it is not an. It is not only dissolving. It is going for reaction with water. That's why oxide is becoming hydroxide. Sir, whether it is going for reaction or not, how do we know? That we will see. Now, sodium oxide is a ionic compound, so we can write that one in the form of ions. Sodium oxide is ionic compound, so we have written in the form of ions. Then this water we will write. Now, sodium hydroxide we will write in the form of ions. Okay, this is completely two types. Okay, completely two types. Now I will cancel a spectator ion. Spectator ion means one which not involving in chemical reaction. Sodium ions not involving in chemical reaction. So I will cancel them. So what is the remaining in the sense? Oxide plus water gives what in the sense? Hydroxide two types. Hydroxide two types. That means what? This water we can write it as. This water we can write it as what in the sense? H plus OH minus. This oxide I am writing. This oxide takes this H plus. Okay. This oxide takes this H plus and becomes hydroxide. This hydroxide we have written as it is. Correct? This oxide takes H plus and becomes hydroxide. Remaining hydroxide we have written. Okay. That's what here taken place. So if you dissolve sodium oxide in water, you will get sodium hydroxide, but not aqueous solution of sodium oxide. Sir. So one general concept we are saying, if oxide dissolves in water, generally if metal oxide dissolves in water, that will give metal hydroxide. Okay. So if you dissolve metal oxide in water, that will become metal hydroxide. That means oxide is not existing in aqueous solution. That's why oxide is not existing in aqueous solution, because it is unstable. Therefore it is reacting with water and becomes hydroxide. That means hydroxide exists in aqueous solution, but oxide is not existing in aqueous solution. Oxide is unstable in aqueous solution. Oxide will react with water. This reaction is takes place very easily. Therefore, here now we will go to this screen top equation. In this equilibrium, we will take now. From this point, this oxide cannot exist in aqueous solution. We came to know oxide cannot exist in aqueous solution means it is unstable. It will react with water. That means it takes H plus from hydronium ion and comes back OH minus. OH minus exists in aqueous solution. Oxide cannot exist in aqueous solution. Therefore, in this one, backward is dominant. Forward is almost nil. Forward is nil. Backward is dominant. Backward takes place completely. Forward is not at all taking place. So forward is not at all taking place in the sense. Now if forward is not taking place, only backward. Now we will say acidic strength of hydroxide and acidic strength of hydronium ion, which will have higher value. That means hydronium ion or OH minus, which will have higher acidic strength. Hydronium ion and OH minus, which will have higher acidic strength? Hydronium ion. And forward is not taking place. Forward is not taking place means water is not acting as a base. That means water is not taking H plus. OH minus is not acting as an acid because it is not giving H plus. That means it is unable to, this OH minus is unable to give H plus to water. That's why it is not giving. That's why it is not accepting. That means OH minus is unable to give H plus to water means OH minus acidic strength is less than that of water. Therefore, OH minus is coming under very weak acids. Okay, so OH minus is a very weak acid. Therefore, OH minus in the sense we have to treat that as a base. Okay, now I will say one substance. That substance is a, it is coming under which category you have to say, whether it is very weak acid or weak acid or strong acid. In which category it comes, that you have to say. Okay, now I will take NH2 minus. NH2 minus is called amide. This amide I will add in water. Okay, this amide, sorry. So what we are getting in the sense, NH3 and OH minus. Okay, now this NH2 minus we are adding into water, we are getting NH3 and OH minus. Now I will take sodamide. Sodamide formula is NaNH2. This I will add in water. What happens means a reaction takes place. We are getting sodium hydroxide and ammonia. This reaction is vigorous reaction. It is not taking place slowly. It is vigorous reaction, very fast. So now you say, shall we store sodamide in water? We cannot. Therefore only, sodamide will be stored in which one in the sense? In liquor ammonia. Liquor ammonia. What is liquor ammonia? Liquor ammonia in the sense, it is nothing but concentrated ammonia. Concentrated ammonia we can say. So we have to store sodamide in which one in the sense, we are storing sodamide in liquor ammonia. Sir, now I will take ammonia. This ammonia I will add into water. In what way I am taking, I am writing equation means ammonia I am writing acid, water I am writing base. So ammonia is donating H plus to water. So water is taking H plus. So ammonia donates H plus and becomes NH2 minus. Water takes H plus from ammonia and becomes hydronium ion. Okay. Now as per backward, NH2 minus takes H plus from hydronium ion and becomes ammonia, therefore base. H3O plus becomes water by giving H plus, therefore it is acid. Now we will see the acidic strength. Now acidic strength of ammonia we will see, and acidic strength of hydronium ion we'll see. Then acidic strength of ammonia and acidic strength of water. Let us compare. Okay. Now you see that this reaction vigorous in the sense. This we can write Na plus NH2 minus. NH2 minus cannot exist in aqueous solution. It is unstable in aqueous solution. It will react with water vigorously. Therefore, NH2 minus cannot exist in aqueous solution in the sense, NH2 minus is reacting with water in the sense, in this equilibrium, the backward dominant, forward is nil. Forward is nil in the sense, now we can say how the acidic strength will be there, means like this. Therefore, we can say ammonia is a very weak acid, we can say. Ammonia is a very weak acid. Okay. So which and all very weak acid, that we got an idea. Okay. So these and all very weak acid, these and all weak acid, these and all strong acids. Now we will say relative acidic strength, we will say which is having higher acidic strength, which is having lower acidic strength, that we will see now. Okay. Now we will take this acetic acid. This acetic acid, let us dissolve in water. Let us dissolve acetic acid in water. It becomes aqueous solution. This acetic acid ionizes in water to give what in the sense? Acetate ion and H plus ion. Let us take acetic acid 1 molar initially. It is dissociating to give X molar. It is dissociating X molar. So how much remaining in the sense? 1 minus X molar at equilibrium. So acetate ion, how much produced means X molar, H plus produced X molar. Acetate ion produced X molar, H plus is produced X molar, we can say. Now for this equilibrium constant is 1.8 into 10 to the power of minus 5. For this equilibrium, equilibrium constant is 10 power minus 5. Okay. Now we will take another weak acid. We will take, that is HCN we will take. So HCN dissociates to give what in the sense? H plus aqueous and CN minus aqueous. HCN aqueous dissociates to give H plus aqueous and CN minus aqueous. Now we will see, initially HCN we will take 1 molar. It is dissociating how much in the sense Y molar. At equilibrium, how much HCN is there means 1 minus Y molar, H plus Y molar, CN minus Y molar. For this equilibrium constant, we'll see, for this equilibrium constant is 10 to the power of minus 10. Now you see the equilibrium constant for this acetic acid, equilibrium constant for HCN, you see this equilibrium constant is roughly 10 power 5 times greater than this equilibrium constant. This equilibrium constant is roughly 10 power 5 times greater than this equilibrium constant. Therefore, we can say this X and this Y, if we compare, where which will be high in the sense, this X will be greater than Y, we can say. H plus is higher, this X is higher magnitude, this Y is lower magnitude. That means H plus concentration is higher. H plus concentration is higher. H plus concentration is less here. That means this gives more amount of H plus. This gives less concentration of H plus. That means it is dissociating to more extent. It is dissociating to less extent. That means it is having higher acidic strength. It is having lower acidic strength. Now you say HCN and acetic acid, which is having higher acidic strength, you can say now, okay, isn't it? So that you are saying that acetic acid is having higher acidic strength, HCN is having lower acidic strength, you are saying. Then, suppose you are asked that what is strong acid means, immediately you will say HCl, otherwise H2SO4, you will say strong acid, isn't it? That means this H2SO4 is a strong acid, we are saying. HCl is a strong acid, we are saying. We are not saying acetic acid is a strong acid, example, isn't it? Suppose if sulfuric acid falls over the skin, that skin will be burnt. Skin will be burnt and a continuous burning sensation will be there till that part is washed with the sodium carbonate solution. That means sulfuric acid is a highly dehydrating agent. Therefore, it is taking water molecules from the skin. Therefore, burning sensation will be there, and it will, where it is falling, that part will burn off. So that this acidic strength, how this acidic strength will be there, you think it. Sulfuric acid, acidic strength, how much will be there, you think it. Now acetic acid. Acetic acid we are using as a preservative. Preservative for pickles we are using. Where we are using, in the sense, commercial name is vinegar. In the vinegar is a dilute solution of acetic acid. Dilute solution of acetic acid is called vinegar. So it is used as a preservative. Therefore, how this acidic strength will be there, you think it. So acetic acid, acidic strength, and sulfuric acid, acidic strength, how it will be there, you think it. Okay, so we can say that acetic acid, acidic strength is less, sulfuric acid, acidic strength is high. Okay, this point. Therefore, we came to know that sulfuric acid, acidic strength is high, acetic acid, acidic strength is less, we said. Now we are taking methane. Methane gas, suppose we are asking, say an example for acid in the sense, any time, do we say methane is an example? No, not at all. Methane, we are not saying as an example for acid. Therefore, how the acidic strength of methane will be there? You think it, very low. Okay, then hydrogen. Do we say hydrogen is an acid? No. Ammonia in the sense, we will say that is a base. Hydroxide in the sense, we will say that is as a base. Therefore, for them, acidic strength is low. Therefore, if we go like this, how the acidic strength changes, do you think? If you go like this, how the acidic strength changes? So, acidic strength, what happens if we go like this? Acidic strength increases, we can say. If you go like this, acidic strength, what happens means acidic strength increases. Sorry. We said we have taken HCN one example, acetic acid one example, and we have explained here. Acetic acid, for acetic acid, equilibrium constant is 10 power minus 5. HCN, equilibrium constant is 10 power minus 10. For acetic acid, equilibrium constant is 10 power 5 times greater than that of HCN. Therefore, acetic acid, acidic strength is more than that of HCN, we said. Like that, can we say this strong acids? Can we say this strong acids? That we'll see. Okay. Can we say for even this strong acid or not? That we'll take. Okay. Now we will take what in the sense? One strong acid HBr we'll take. One strong acid HCl we'll take. Can we explain like this or not? That we'll see. Okay. Now I will take HCl. I will take exactly 1 mole of HCl gas, and I will pass 1 mole of HCl gas into water, and I will prepare one molar HCl solution. 1 molar HCl solution I have prepared. Okay. Then this HCl dissociates in water to give hydronium ion and Cl minus aqueous. Now it is dissociating. HCl is dissociating in water, and it is coming for equilibrium. It is coming for equilibrium. Okay. In equilibrium, hydronium ion, how much is there? Means nearly 1 molar will be there. That means we can say that HCl dissociates completely. Therefore, at equilibrium, undissociated HCl is not there. It is completely dissociating. So, hydronium ion 1 molar present, we can say. Next, we will take HBr, we will take. It is also strong acid. This we will dissolve in water. Then we will get hydronium ion and Br minus ion. Let us take 1 molar initially. It is dissociating completely. At equilibrium, nothing is there. Hydronium ion 1 molar present at equilibrium. Okay. That means HBr is dissociating completely. Now see, we are saying that HCl is dissociating completely. HCl dissociating completely means in the aqueous solution, hydronium ion is existing or HCl is existing? We are saying HCl is dissociating completely. That means in the aqueous solution, hydronium ion is existing or HCl is existing. What shall we say? HCl dissociating completely means in the aqueous solution, HCl is not existing. Hydronium ion only is existing. That is the mean, isn't it? Similarly, HBr dissociating completely in the sense in the aqueous solution, hydronium ion is existing, HBr is not existing. Therefore, name the strong acid which exists in aqueous solution. What shall we say? Name the strong acid which exists in aqueous solution. What shall we say? Name the strong acid which exists in aqueous solution. Suppose if we take methane. If you dissolve methane in water, the dissolved methane will be there as it is in the water. If you dissolve acetic acid in the water, undissociated acetic acid will be there in aqueous solution. That means acetic acid is existing in aqueous solution. But if you dissolve HCl in water, HCl is not existing. That means which strong acid exists in aqueous solution means hydronium ion. So the strongest acid which exists in aqueous solution is what in the sense? We can say hydronium ion, we can say. Okay, HCl we should not say, because HCl dissociates completely. Similarly, HBr also dissociating completely. So that we cannot say HBr existing in aqueous solution. Sorry. Now we can say HCl is strong acid, HBr also strong acid, that we discussed already. Out of HCl and HBr, which is having higher acidic strength, HCl and HBr, which is having higher acidic strength. How do we know? Now, here HCl dissociated completely. HBr also dissociated completely. Then how do we say which is having higher acidic strength? Whether HCl or HBr, how do we say? We can't say using water. That means HCl and HBr, do they have same nature? No. They are having different nature, means certainly acidic strength will be different. At least a minute amount, acidic strength will be different, certainly. Then how to distinguish acidic strength of HCl and HBr? Using water, is it possible or not? It is not possible. Because HCl is completely dissociating, HBr also completely dissociating. Actually, HCl and HBr nature is different. Then how they have gone for complete dissociation? That means water made HCl and HBr to dissociate completely. That means water makes HCl and HBr to have same acidic strength. Water levels the acidic strength of HCl and HBr to have same value. Therefore, this effect is called leveling effect. This effect we can call it as leveling effect. Therefore, water is called a leveling solvent. So, using solvent water, we cannot distinguish acidic strength of different strong acids. Therefore, we are taking some other solvent to distinguish acidic strength of strong acids. What is that? That we will see. Now we will take HCl, we will take the solvent acetic acid. Now, in this one, HCl is becoming Cl minus, acetic acid is becoming like this. Using this acetic acid solvent, we can distinguish HCl acidic strength and HBr acidic strength. Therefore, acetic acid is called a differentiating solvent. Acetic acid, we can call it as a differentiating solvent because it distinguishes acidic strength of different strong acids. As per acetic acid, or using differentiating solvent acetic acid, we can say acidic strength of strong acids increases in this order. That means perchloric acid is having higher acidic strength than HI, which is greater than HBr, greater than sulfuric acid, greater than HCl, greater than nitric acid. So strong acids acidic strength we have determined using differentiating solvent acetic acid, but not water. Okay, using water we cannot say acidic strength of these. Water makes all these acids to have same acidic strength that of hydronium ion. Therefore, using water we cannot distinguish these acidic strengths. Only using acetic acid, differentiating solvent only, we can distinguish these acidic strength. Okay. Now we will see these acids corresponding conjugate bases. We will see their basic strength, how it will be there, that we'll see. Now, HClO4 is an acid. It's a conjugate base in the sense, remove one H plus from here, you will get conjugate base, that is ClO4 minus, conjugate base. Sulfuric acid we are taking. It's a conjugate base, means conjugate acid base pair should differ by one H plus. Therefore, in the sulfuric acid, remove one H plus, you will get its conjugate base, that is HSO4 minus. Like that, for OH minus, it's a conjugate base you want, in the sense, you treat this as an acid. So let it donate H plus. What is the remaining? O2 minus, that is its conjugate base. Now we will take hydrogen. Its conjugate base is what? H minus.